A lot of digital coloring methods involve adding some flat colors first. Most of the time, people would just use the paint bucket tool to add them quickly. While it might be fast, it's not exactly perfect. Personally, I am not a fan of this method because my art style revolves around reducing the opacity of the line art so it looks slightly lineless. The reason for that is when I reduce the opacity of the line art, it leaves these pesky gaps that look absolutely jarring on the finished piece. So in today's video, I'll be showing you my way of adding flat colors to the drawing that is fairly easy, doesn't leave any gaps, and you only need to use one layer. Trust me, you would want to use just one layer for flats because once you get to the painting stage, these layers start to pile up and it can get very confusing and your PC will start to lag. So the less layers you use, the better. We will still use the paint bucket tool, but we will tweak the settings to suit our needs. More on that later. First and foremost, make sure that you already prep your line art. You already cleaned it, you removed the whites, and most importantly, there's no aliasing. Ideally, you should just have black inks with a transparent background like this sample here. If you want to learn how to prep your line art, check out the video link on the top right corner of the screen. I'll put that in the description as well if you prefer that. You can use Photoshop or Clip Studio for this as all the tools we'll be using are available on both softwares. Step 1 is to create a layer underneath the ink layer. Let's rename it by double-clicking the layer name. We'll call it Flats. Now, this is optional but you can also add a layer underneath our newly created flats layer and fill it with gray. Just so we can see our line art better because those white and gray checkers are so painful to the eyes. Back to our flat layer. Our first priority is selecting the entire subject, not including the background. The easiest way to do this is by using magic wand tool. Before we do our selection, make sure to uncheck anti-alias. It's very important that the anti-aliasing is turned off because it'll give us a solid flat color. I explained what anti-aliasing is in the previous video. If you like to learn more, video link, top right of the screen, you know the drill. On Photoshop, this option is usually positioned on the top part of the software. So let's uncheck that, and while we're here, let's leave contiguous and sample all layers checked. For Clip Studio, however, since people arrange their windows differently, I'm just gonna mention where you can find these windows on the menu if you can't see it on your own screen. So in Clip Studio, we have this window called the sub tool. And when you click the magic wand, you will be presented with a couple of options here. For this, we're going to select the option refer to all layers. Now to turn off anti-aliasing, we're going to go to the window called tool property. Ignore all the other options here and just uncheck anti-aliasing at the bottom. To create a selection, just click on the area you want to be selected. We want to select the area around the subject. Now you might be going, wait, what? I thought we're going to fill the character. Why are we selecting the outside area? Stick with me here, okay? Calm down. We can tell which area is selected because it's being bordered by these moving lines, which I like to call marching ants. Now, if you notice some marching ants inside the characters, you might have left a gap somewhere. So in order to fix that, deselect by pressing Ctrl D, go to your line art layer, and just draw on the gap with the brush or pencil tool, and then reapply the magic wand. Once you ensure that the marching ants aren't infecting the insides of the drawing, what we're gonna do is go to the select menu and click inverse for Photoshop or invert selected area on Clip Studio. You can also just press Shift plus Ctrl plus I on your keyboard. What it does is select the areas we didn't select, so now the selection is around the drawing itself. Now it's time to fill it. Select a color of your character that has the biggest surface area. For this example, the biggest surface area would be her shirt, which I want to be a light blue-green color. We'll be using the paint bucket to fill it. If you're using Photoshop, make sure you set the tolerance to 0. Leave anti-aliasing, contiguous, and sample all layers unchecked. For Clip Studio, in the sub-tool window, select refer only to editing layer, and on the tool property window, make sure everything is unchecked. So now when we click our drawing, it will fill the entire thing, ignoring the line art. And if we zoom in here, since we turn off anti-aliasing, everything is just one solid color. Next, we'll be filling the other parts of the drawing, starting from the biggest surface area to the smallest. So the next area we need to fill is the skin. Let's pick the color for the skin, and for this, we're not going to use the magic wand for selection, but instead, we're going to use the lasso tool. Again, make sure to uncheck the anti-aliasing option and we're just gonna freehand select the skin area. You don't need to do it in one go. What you can do is select a small area and then hold shift on your keyboard and select another part and keep doing that until you selected the entire area you want to fill. To fill it, we're gonna use the paint bucket tool, same setting as before, and we're just gonna click on the selected area. After that, we're moving on to the hair. To make the selection easier, you can actually select some parts of the skin now since we already changed the color of this. Don't worry, because when we use the fill tool, the selected areas around the skin will not be affected and will only fill the hair area. By the way, you can actually select over the edge. This is absolutely fine. To explain how this works better, I drew different shapes with different colors. By unchecking these three settings on the paint bucket tool, what it does is it will only fill in the color where you click. So here, even though we selected a part of this shape, since I click on the red, this is the only thing that will be filled, and the black will be unaffected. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment below. We'll keep doing this selecting and filling process until we fill every area with their respective colors. And we're done with the flats! Yay! In order to show that there are no gaps between the fills, let's hide the line art layer and zoom in. You can see that everything is filled and in solid color, which is ideal when using the magic wand to select once we do the shading. We'll be discussing how to add shading in a future video, so be sure to subscribe so you won't miss any updates. In the meantime, if you want to learn how to do some different shading on faces, you can click this video right here.